Hey guys, it's Lance at Max Sound Solutions, and today I'm going on a little adventure. I've installed Big Sur and Pro Tools 2021 on my Mac Pro 5.1, which is running Opencore, but I installed it on a separate SSD. I did not install it over my current working system drive, which is Catalina with Opencore and Pro Tools 2019. You know, when Apple comes out with a big new release, it always takes Avid a long time to catch up and get a compatible version of Pro Tools running with it, which they've finally done. But there's always quirks, there's always plugins that aren't going to work. So it's a gradual thing. You can't just leap in and expect it all to be working from day one. So I'm doing a test drive. I'll slowly install all my plugins. And once it all seems to be great, then I'll probably make the switch. So, you know, after trying it out for a week, everything seemed pretty good. A few of my Waves plugins weren't available, but that's because the installation was on my other system drive. So yesterday, I installed Big Sur onto the Catalina drive. It's up and running now. I did have to jump through a couple of hoops, and I'm just going to show you the install process and what I went through. But overall, everything seems good. So if you want to watch the install, you can hang out. And if you don't, see you later. Please subscribe to my channel. Hit the thumbs up or the thumbs down. And let's get to the install. So just a couple of notes before we go forward. Always make a bootable clone of your system before installing a new version of macOS. I use Carbon Copy Cloner to do this. It's extremely reliable. So if something goes wrong, you can revert back to your older system. Number two, if you want to run Big Sur, you must first install Martin Lowe's easy-to-install OpenCore package that was specifically made for Mac Pro 5.1s. It is only for Mac Pro 5.1s. And you must be coming from Mojave or Catalina. If you have Catalina running, chances are you already installed OpenCore, because Mojave is the last supported OS by Apple with the Mac Pro 5.1. Of course, you do this at your own risk, but it is easy and it works great. I have left links in the description to Martin Lowe's YouTube channel. He has how-to videos on there and a link to his Mac Rumors page where you can download his latest version of the OpenCore package for the 5.1. Okay, so thanks to OpenCore, you can just use the typical software update in the system preferences. Hit update now, which is going to download the Big Sur installer. And we're going to fast forward through that. And once we get done with that, we're going to hit upgrade now. And then this window opens up. Then you agree to Apple's lengthy terms. And then we hit continue. Type in your administrative password and hit OK. Okay, so I sped this part way up because it did take about 16 minutes. And then the computer reboots. So with my setup, I have three monitors, and the boot picker for OpenCore only shows up on one monitor, and that is my monitor connected via DisplayPort. My other two monitors are connected via HDMI. So you can see the boot picker here. And what's interesting, after the first round of install, the computer rebooted and it selected the installer again. And it's doing further installations. I would have thought that it was a one-shot deal and would have booted up off the system drive. But no, it had to do a second reboot off the installer, which it automatically picked. I did not have to pick it. So this was like another 10-15 minute process. And then it rebooted yet again. And third time's a charm. It booted into the system drive and Big Sur appears. Goodbye, Catalina. Now it also took a little time before it got to this accessibility screen. So it was still doing stuff. Probably cleaning out some of the old cobwebs in my old system. And then you just go through and follow the usual stuff here and set up your computer.
Just a little side note is, you know, Avid will state that you should really install Pro Tools on a clean macOS drive, meaning you formatted it, you installed the new operating system from scratch, like it's going onto a computer that's never been used before, and then install Pro Tools. I can't do that. My Mac Pro is from 2009. I've got way too much time invested in customizations, in software authorizations, all that stuff, and there's no way I'm going to do it from scratch and reinstall all my software. It just takes way too long. I would spend a week doing it, and I probably wouldn't get it back to the way I had my system. So I install over the OS once I test out the OS, and that's why you need to clone your operating system so that you can revert back if there's a problem. But clean install, I know it's the right way to go. There's no way I am going to do that. So I don't roll that way. I'm not recommending you do what I do, which is to install it over the old system. But I've been doing that for years, and it really honestly hasn't been a problem.
So Big Sur and Pro Tools is now installed, so let's give Pro Tools a test run. Pro Tools does not find my iLock, which is plugged into my USB 3 hub, which is plugged into my USB 3 PCIe card. And I noticed that also one of my hard drives wasn't showing up that was also plugged into the same hub. So I went through this the first time I installed Big Sur. I had issues with my USB 3 card, and the way I fixed this was to do a SMC reset. So I shut down the Mac Pro and unplugged the power from the back of the computer for about 10 minutes. And then I came back. Then I held down the power button for about 15 seconds and then plugged it back in and rebooted. Then one of my drives came to life, but the iLock was still being stubborn. When it was connected to the USB hub, it would not show up. So I plugged it into the USB 2 port directly into the Mac Pro, launched Pro Tools, everything was fine. It was seeing the iLock. I then quit Pro Tools, moved the iLock back to the USB 3 hub, and bingo, it now worked. Why this went on, I'm not really sure. But if you have the same problem, just unplug the device from your hub, plug it into one of the main ports, and then put it back, and that seemed to do the trick. So I'm not really sure the SMC reset did anything, although maybe it helped that one hard drive. I had to do the same thing that I did with the iLock with another one of my hard drives. It just would not show up when it was plugged into the USB 3 card. So I plugged it into the USB 2 port on the Mac Pro, it showed up, then I moved it back. Bingo, there it was. So I just went through and checked a bunch of my plugins and ran sort of a stress test on the system, tried some low buffer settings like down to 32, and Pro Tools seemed to be working really well. Opened up one of my mixes, had no issues so far. Of course, it's only been a day that I've had it installed, so we'll see how it goes. I can always revert to my backup if I have to, but I think I'm probably good. Okay, so it's been a few days now, and I gotta say Big Sur is very perky. It feels really smooth on my Mac Pro 5.1 with RX 5700 XT. I know that some people with the 7.1 Mac Pros had issues with non-Apple RX 5700 XTs. They had driver issues, but I've had absolutely none, and you know, of course, we're up to Big Sur 11.2.3. It's known that the 11.3 beta is not working with the Mac Pro 5.1, so keep that in mind. I never jump into betas anyway. You do that on a separate drive if you're going to do it to make sure things work as usual. You don't do it over your main system drive. So Big Sur 11.2.3 as of now is the last potential update for Mac Pro 5.1s with Opencore. Without Opencore, you're stuck in Mojave. But with Opencore, you can get up to 11.2.3. It's known that the 11.3 beta does not work with the Mac Pro 5.1 as of now, but the genius of Martin Lowe and the guys at Opencore might be able to fix that. Only time will tell. Okay, thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. Give me the thumbs up or the thumbs down. I prefer the thumbs up, of course. And hit that little bell icon if you want to be notified the next time I upload a video. And we'll see you on the next Max Sound Solutions video.